everyone. Thank you for joining me. My name is Carlos. Today I'm going to be presenting a back workout, back session, getting into the ins and outs of hypertrophy training. Excuse me while I adjust this. There we go. And it'll be all very productive, entertaining, and of high value. I hope so. Anyways, before we do that, please hit that subscribe button, leave a comment, post notifications, all that good stuff. So, we're in the middle of a bulking season, trying to gain as much muscle as possible, eating a surplus amount of calories, and training as hard as we can. Now, some training sessions, especially for the back, are very heavy because there is an extensive arsenal of tools that we use to train our back. Some are much more strenuous than others. Some have a high effort to recuperation ratio. In other words, they require a great deal of effort, take a long time to recuperate, and don't seem to have a great reward ratio, but they need to be done, such as the deadlift, the back row, the barbell back row, and exercises of this nature, power cleans, which I haven't been doing, but these exercises are very strenuous. You use very heavy weights, hopefully, and you get very little out of it. I mean, but they are necessary because that little that you do gain from it is absolutely determinant in your overall gains in the larger scheme of things. In other words, the deadlift should never be excluded if you are serious about gaining maximum size and muscle. The barbell row, also very important to do with very heavy weights. So the thing is, again, the recuperation from these, it's not easy to recuperate like on a dime from those exercises. You're not going to be doing them twice a week. At least I can't. The deadlift I do like once every 3 to 4 weeks to make gains, I'm not training the deadlift. I'm using them to make gains. So I use it here and there. I don't lose strength on it. I do if I train them continuously. If I go and do deadlifts twice a week or even once a week, I generally backslide. Like if I'm doing reps with 4 plates, I can do 5, 6, building them up to 7 or 8. I'll go into the gym, you know, off, you know, my 3rd or 4th session and I won't be able to do 4 plates. It's like a backsliding thing for me with that particular exercise because of where I am in life, my age, my personal training habits and all of this do not permit that. So what am I going on about? The different arsenals. So one session may be really heavy barbell rows. Like at the beginning of the week, I did 3 plates for the barbell rows. It felt great. I felt the working of every single muscle because I noticed it on the DOMS the next few days that the back is, you know, it's pumped. It's like, okay, the heavy weight hit me a certain way. And then I go in for my next back session, and I say to myself, there's just no way I'm going to do those 3 plates. It's not in the cards today. I don't have either the disposition, or I just don't want to. I don't have the strength, whatever it may be. So I do a different routine. And so today was that different routine. I hadn't done this in a while, which is very high volume cable pulldowns. Doing these pulldowns with a straight bar, the neutral grip, and the independent cables. Man, oh man, my back is really feeling it. It's a different work. I feel that it's bringing on some muscle gain for sure. It's the mixing up of these things. It's not like you got to stay 8 weeks with this particular movement and then 8 weeks with that. That's great when you're beginning to train, but after you've been doing this for years, you can change much more quickly. You can incorporate different training styles within a block. You can have a heavy day. You can have a light day. You can have a high rep day, a low rep day. It's not going to deload you. It's not going to detrain you, detract you, whatever. It's not going to hinder your progress. It's going to help by mixing it up a little. As long as your general training track is going upward. It's intensifying over time. You're not doing these easy sessions each and every time and ignoring your heavy lifts. So this is what I'm going on about today. Oh, the other thing is the heavy military presses. I'm not recuperating that fast from these things. It's like I did a heavy military press, say, on a Thursday, and on Monday I went in to do my bench press, and it really suffered. Like, my shoulders were still tired or tight or somewhat in pain, and I just couldn't, I didn't have the strength to do my proper bench press routine. So I told myself, next week, since the bench press is a priority for me, that I'm going to modify my shoulder session and just nail the raises, like just nail the dumbbells and the cables. And that's exactly what I did. And again, a different feel, a different different gains, but it's like, I can't say that that is the way to train. It definitely would seem that way from the gains I made on that session. I said, man, these dumbbells, I did six sets of dumbbell rear, the dumbbell flies from the rear, with 20s, 25s, 30s, 40s, and brought them down to 15s, and just did a whole lot of reps. And man, my delts are definitely feeling it. Then I went to the cable, on the cable machine, and did these like super strict flies on the cable. Had one of the trainers at the gym, he's a competitor, and he said, no, just do them like this. Like, don't even consider the weight. It was like on the minimum pin, and did very lightweight, didn't seem light, felt very heavy, and the benefit was outrageous. It was great. But that's not the system of training to gain ultimate size and mass. It's a complement to throw into the mix, and then it has that benefit. It has that awesome, great result. The thing is, people get enamored with these quick results from pumps, and they think that's the way to always train. And you couldn't be further from the truth. Or else bodybuilders would not try to lift heavier weights every single time if it's not necessary. Yeah, you can build muscle with lightweight, but what kind of muscle? I mean, how much do you want to build? You can build some muscle. You're not going to build great physiques with light weights. That's just complete bullshit. And somebody will point to some bodybuilder in the past who built a great physique with low weights and high reps and high volume. But, you know, you're not that person, first of all. And this is the way we've reached this stage through trial and error to understand you don't have to be so stubborn, that there is a way to build maximum muscle, and it does entail extreme mechanical tension. In other words, you got to get stronger than what you are, than where you are today. That's just a fact. And that's where I am. So I'm trying to get stronger. But these sessions that are light pump sessions, quote unquote, thrown into the mix, are a joy. They are. They're a lot of fun. They're also a psychological break from the heavy lifting. The heavy lifting in and of itself is difficult, but what's even more difficult is the psychology before you even get to the gym thinking about that type of session when you're not completely jazzed up. Not every time you're going, man, I just can't wait to get to the gym. I just want to bomb it. I want to bend those bars. That happens sometimes, but not always. Sometimes you just don't feel that energy before starting a workout. You might get into it as you warm up and as the adrenaline kicks in, and if you're pre-workout or whatever. But these plan B type of routines really have a great effect on your mind, or at least they do on mine. I want to come in on my next back session and do those three plates again, this time for 5 reps, maybe a few more sets, maybe cluster them. I mean, just, you know, I want to get really good with those 3 plates before I take the weight up again, taking advantage of the bulk, these extra calories. It's like the food gives you a lot of strength, man. That's why the strongman people eat so many calories. It's, you know, you burn more calories doing cardio, but to gain that type of power and strength, you need a lot of food. You know, food helps. So, taking advantage of that, because when you get into prep, you want to get into a cut and on a diet. It's not the best time to be going for max PRs and lifting heavy barbell rows and doing these maximum, you know, low rep type of weights. That's the time you put in the work, you already did your heavy lifting, you did your bulk and everything. Now it's to preserve the muscle, do your hypertrophy routines, you bring up the volume, lower the weights, and it's a different scheme. Anyway, so the pull downs. Did one set of barbell rows with the underhand grip. I really don't like this move. I've tried it a few times. It does not feel natural to me. Because I'm so strong with the overhand grip, this underhand grip, I just can't get the force into it. It's on me. You know, I should be stronger on it. I really don't like it. And I don't know if, you know, I threw it in today because it was a low weight day. And I figured, well, you know, just pump one plate. And I did. I did one set with 12, with one plate with the underhand grip. And you get a better contraction on the lat. You get greater range of motion, but you also sacrifice a great deal of mechanical tension. In other words, the load is just not enough. And again, it's like working the muscle with lighter weight may seem like the way to go because it inflates the muscle temporarily. But it's not a permanent long-term solution to building muscle. It's something that you throw into the mix here and there so it can increase the size of the muscle as you gain real size, real strength, and real mass, real muscle with heavy weights, with real strength. So, after that, what else did we do? Calves, man. Not ignoring those calves. I'm starting to get excited about them because it's easy to get deflated and depressed with your calves if you don't make progress. And like you have a nice physique, your shoulders are wide, you got, you know, big arms, whatever, your legs are they're coming up, but your calves are kind of skinny, and you work them and you work them and they don't grow. I can see how you can get discouraged and, you know, just unmotivated for training them. I have had decent calves in the past, and that came from doing these calf raises just relentlessly for months. And you know, one day I woke up, shit, I got some nice calves. You know, they got the diamond shape, they're nice and cut, they got the nice flare on the outside, they're not huge, bubbly, massive calves yet. But, you know, I gave up on them because, you know, just laziness, and I wasn't really taking the training that seriously. But now I am. Now I am taking it very seriously. I haven't missed a calf workout in the last few months. And today, you know, in this particular session, I threw a lot of volume at it. I did at least eight sets of the calf raises. And each set, like, was just a burner, man. Those calves were burning. Don't stretch all the way down. It's a great way to hurt your Achilles tendon. Just bring it down enough so the load is on the muscle. And then peak contraction is what you want. If you can look at yourself in the mirror and do the peak contraction, you'll understand what I'm saying. Because you can actually see the muscle being formed as you peak it. And you crunch it. And you say, okay. Man, if you could do that, like in an out-of-body experience, you're looking at yourself in the mirror and working your own self, like just as the other over there, just bringing those calves up. So I'm excited with the progress. It's slow. It's very, it's just a slow process. But it will work. The calves will grow if you stay consistently, persistently on point with your calf training. And at least once a week. But you can't be training consistently and then take a couple of weeks off. It's like calf training is not on your train. It's just something that you forgot to do that day and you don't do them. And then you end up like never doing them. Well, you're never going to get great calves. Now, as far as training them three times a week, I don't think that works either. It wouldn't work for me. Twice a week is great. Fine. Now, the seated calf raise is also what I see has been really helping, but it has required going above and beyond the normal weights that I use. So I always use like two or three plates, the 45-pound plates on the seated, and now I won't go below four plates, but then I can't do more than eight reps. And I do them very conscientiously, man. I make that muscle work. I focus the entire strength and all the force, all the weight on that calf muscle, even if it's just a few reps. So I leave it for last. It's the last exercise I do after all that high volume with the dumbbell calf raises. And I've noticed on the video that, you know, it's working. I mean, it's working perfectly. That's the way to work the muscle, you know, just with all that weight, you crunch it, you hold it there for a second, bring it, what else can you do? I mean, I don't know what else to do. And I put on the maximum weight that I can use. I'm doing high reps, so I'm trying to do it all. That beside, what else could I do? Occupational hypertrophy. What does that mean? Like a cycle, you know, bicycle every single day, like speed, circuit training, you know, for 10, 15 minutes, calf emphasis. You know, jog up a hill on one foot. I don't know what else, you know, do that daily. I don't know what else could work for my calves. So I'm doing what I can. Now, what else did we do today? That was basically it. Warmed up a little bit longer on the cardio. So now instead of 10 minutes, it was 15 minutes with the bicycle at a little higher level. Just pushed it up a notch, about 20% higher. So I was doing, say, registers 10. On the meter, I'm doing 12 now, and not 10 minutes, but 15 minutes for the warm-up, and it's feeling great. It's just the cardio is something I'm looking forward, actually, to doing again once I get into my prep mode, which I hope won't be too soon. I hope this bulk started in October, November, December. It's been 2 months. You know, I'm trying to make it for at least 6 to 7 months of steady calorie surplus with maybe, you know, I pull it back here and there, bring down the carbs for, you know, 2, 3, 4 days. And I don't really bring them down. It's just like I stop shoveling food into myself, like, you know, like really packing in the food. I'll back off and just eat like normally, like a lot of food, but no snacks, no junks, not eating out, not eating junk food, fast food, none of that. Just my prepared meals. It's just I do have a proclivity of eating a lot. Like, I have no problem eating like 3 pounds of potatoes or a kilo of rice. I can do that. So I'm very careful at certain points to back off a little bit because it's necessary to do so. You don't want to get fat. So what else can I share today about today's session? The video is at the end with the training. And, I just can't really think about anything else to say about the training today other than it's great to have a heavy day and it's great to have a light day. I can't wait for my next back session because I really want to do the back rows again. And maybe in the coming weeks I'll do a deadlift. I don't know. I'm up to 6, 4 plates, 6 reps. My PR is 8. And one of these days, I'm just going to rip up to 10. Like, just, okay, boom, 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 boom. You know, just 10. I'm not really excited about going up in weight. It takes a lot of effort. So, it is what it is. Anyways, guys, love y'all. Thank you for sharing this journey with me, being with me on this bodybuilding journey, getting stronger as we get older. And believe me, I am. So, God bless everybody. See y'all next time.